What's going on, guys? I just recently had a haircut. Let me know whether you like it. So I've been cutting my hair for about 4 years now, saved tons of money, and I do recommend it. So what's going on, guys? In this video, I want to talk to you about this monitor right here behind me, which is the Dell 2719D. So this is what I feel is the best monitor for software. So this is what I feel is the best and most affordable monitor for software engineers. Now, the price it varies, but basically in countries. So I'm in the UK. I got it for around £320. So I guess that would be like 350 euros and maybe $370. Which I feel like is not that expensive compared to, ultra wide and 4K monitors. But yeah, so I feel like this is the perfect size. So usually what I have is I've got, so basically I can split the screen because it's a 27 inch, so I can have maybe if I'm doing like some backend stuff, so then I have the IDE on this side, and then if I've got like some infrastructure or front end that I'm coding as well, I have the other IDE on this side and on this side here, because because I'm using the M1, and the M1 right now it only supports one screen, because otherwise I would have get a second one. So before I used to have two monitors, but I recently got the M1, so that's no longer possible. So yeah, so this is one thing that you have to consider with M1s, which I've done a video earlier this year. But yeah, so in this side right here, so I've got usually a Chrome or my terminal, and I think that that's enough, right? I don't need to have like a bunch of things open. I think like if I can simplify my workflow, the better it is. Now, what I really like about this monitor is that it has really thin bezels. So just have a look, like really thin bezels. You can barely see them unless you are really close. And then the logo, it's right here at the bottom, right? And I think that the logo is quite nice. Yeah, unlike like other monitors where sometimes they have like really big bezels, and then the logo, you can literally see the logo. And for me, if I can hide the logo, the better it is. And yeah, so you can even see like right here, I've got my Bank Screen Plus. So this is what I use at night when I'm coding. You can see that it's actually on top of it, and it basically coincides with the bezels right here, which is like the perfect match. And then on top of it, I've got the webcam. So this is a Logitech 4K webcam, and I think this is the, one of the best combinations. If you want simplicity, right? Now, obviously there are, way more expensive monitors than this one. So the reason why I'm recommending this one is value for money, right? So this is what I used to use in my previous workplace. We had a bunch of these, and yeah, so since then I've been using them. Also, what you've seen on the video, oops, is that it comes with this stand right here, which I don't use basically because I've got the Flexi mount, which was sent to me last year. But yeah, so it's really nice. You can actually swivel, you can tilt, you can have it vertically if you want. So before, I used to have like one vertically, and even one day someone messaged me saying, shall I buy a monitor which is like horizontal or vertically? And I just have to say, like, you just pretty much, you can just basically, I'm not gonna do it, but you get the point, right? But yeah, so that was super funny, to be honest. Yeah, so the monitor has a bunch of ports, so USB, HDMI ports, and also I think this one doesn't include, but I think that there's a slight variation on these models, but one which has USB Type C, which means that you can basically connect to your Mac. It will basically connect the Mac with the monitor and at the same time charge your MacBook, so which is really, really good. So yeah, and I think I didn't mention, but the resolution is 2560 by 1440, and the aspect ratio is 16:9, excuse me there. And the best part for me is that it's good looking, right? So you can see like it's really slick, black bezels, and yeah, nothing can go wrong with this monitor. So go ahead and let me know which is your favorite monitor. I would love to hear from you. And yeah, so if you're not part of the Amigos Code community, please do join, because people usually they post their setup. So I would love to see yours. And yeah, let me know what you want to see next from Amigos Code. And if you haven't subscribed, make sure to subscribe. Give me a thumbs up, comment down below, and I'll catch you in the next one. Assalamu alaikum.